Welcome, 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 everybody. So excited to have you here. My name is Karen. I'm going to be your facilitator today. I am located right outside San Francisco in Marin County. It is not a gorgeous day outside. It's not horrible, but it's definitely not holiday-rific weather. And in the chat, I have the wonderful Maya, who is going to be supporting you there. And usually she pops on camera to give you guys a wave. Maybe not this. Oh, there she is. There she is. So she's going to be supporting you. I supported her this morning. She'll be supporting me tomorrow morning for the weekly setup too. Gotta love it. So glad you guys are here on a holiday weekend and setting yourself up for success, even though it is a little bit of a short week. Some housekeeping to be aware of is to make sure that your chat is set to everyone. If you're on a phone, sometimes it resets. So therefore, you need to make sure you change it unless you want just Maya and I to see it. But a lot of times, someone shares something wonderful and they're like, why is no one commenting? It's because we're the only ones who saw it, not everyone else. So I love this little affirmation here on my right-hand side. This is from our Instagram feed and I have embedded quite a few from Instagram. If you are on Instagram and you are not following Silk and Saunders, follow it. Their stuff is super fun. Oh man, Sarah's already asking who is staying in May and who is going into June. You know, Alyssa, I'm kind of with you. When I have a great month, I like to finish that month. If I was slacking, I like to go into the next one. Maya says for her, if whichever week has the most in it, that's how she decides. Also, some people are doing part of it in May and part of it in June. And that's totally fine. There's no right or wrong way to be able to set this up. Whichever one works for you, works for me. Is there any first timers in the audience today? If there is, let us know. No one new today. Oh, we do. Welcome, Angela. Okay, there are a few. It's just a little bit of a glitch. No, I'm so ready for summer, and that's why I played a summer song. And in this morning's social with Maya, she talked about Sonic Lemon Limeades, and I don't live near any Sonics. I grew up on Sonic. Cherry Lemon Limeade at happy hour was my absolute first and favorite. But my little pro tip is Waterloo from Whole Foods has a cherry limeade water. So I added some cherries and some limes to it to get the summer feeling all good. Those of you who are here for first timers, you're going to love it. Don't get overwhelmed with the chat. You can just take notes, take photos, take screenshots, or you can dive into your journal. It really just kind of depends on what kind of person you are. If you are someone who loves to make gorgeous, scrapbook-worthy pages, you may be better off taking notes and such. If you're someone who's like me, who uses one pen for the whole month, and they just kind of scribble it all into that pen, then you may be totally fine setting yourself up during the social here. So just a couple little reminders. These are our community guidelines. Be kind and courteous to yourself as well as others. No promotions or spam. Respect everyone's privacy, even if you know them outside of Saunders Club. What happens here stays here like Vegas. Limit repeat product and accessory questions. I know a lot of newbies like to know what kind of pens people use, which ones don't bleed through, et cetera. It's fine to answer that question once, but we just don't want it to take over the entire chat for a long period of time. Any kind of customer care questions, you can email hello@silkandsaunders.com. If you're missing pages, it's coming late, you have questions, et cetera. We actually don't work for headquarters. We are contractors. So sometimes we don't have all the answers that we want to be able to give to you. And then the very last one is Saunders Socials are a tool to help elevate your emotional health through the power of community, but you are responsible for your own emotions, well-being, and decisions. So just know that if something doesn't sit right with you today, not weeklies don't really hit those emotions like some of the other journal pages do. It's perfectly fine to color in your page, listen to the music, and hang out in the chat. This is your time you set aside for yourself. There's no right or wrong way to do it. You can participate in the chat, but you don't have to. You can be a lurker. We can't see you. We don't know. It's totally fine. So as we kind of got that housekeeping out of the way, we'll take a look at our agenda. If you are brand new, and there is quite a few new ones today, which I'm so excited to have you here. We do a mind map exploring different areas of the theme. This one is not in your journal. We do this on a separate page, like one of the gridded note pages is a perfect place to utilize it. But like one of these that are just completely and totally blank. But some people really enjoy using their scratch pad that is in your weekly setup, that big column right here, or they actually may use a part of their weekly setup that they don't use. And I'll share some other examples of that. We will do our rosebud thorn. If you are in June, you can choose to finish it up in May, or you can do it on a separate sheet. So if you have your May and June journal with you, that is definitely a fun option. We're going to get our week set up so we have an awesome, successful first week of summer, and then we'll close out. That delight mind map. This month, we've been exploring delight using our five senses. And today we are going to be looking at taste. So as we think about taste, taste is one of those things that can bring me back a flood of memories, almost like a smell. Some of the things that I think about when I am tasting is maybe a s'more over a campfire. Obviously, I'm ready for summer. Or back home, there was a tea room that I used to go to with my mom that would make these tuna fish sandwiches and cheese and broccoli soup. So that definitely resonates with me. But sometimes those memories aren't necessarily so pleasant. When I was a child, I was not able to swallow pills very well, and I was hospitalized with a very rare disease for a couple of weeks, and I ended up missing the entire semester of school. And to this day, I will not eat honey or jello because they would empty the capsule over it, and then it would just, all the bitterness would go into my mouth. So sometimes that taste can be a bad memory or a good memory, but let's focus on the good memories today. Here are some ways other people have set up their five senses. Someone literally just took one of those note pages. Other people really enjoy using their definition page. I love, because there are five senses, that she did five petals of the flower. And then here is just a basic mind map here. So I'm going to go off camera. I'm going to play a quick song. Please let us know what tastes bring back memories for you, or tastes that you absolute delight in. Maybe it's the very first cup of coffee in the morning, or maybe that first bite of dark chocolate or cheesecake. I'll put this back up. I'll go off camera and I'll check back in a couple of minutes. I love hearing everyone's food memories, from grandma's pistachio salad to popcorn, or what you ate when you were hanging out with your family. And one of my favorites, I am from Texas, is that I would go trout lining with my dad and we would always get a big red soda, which I can't even get here in California, corn nuts and beef jerky. And if you put that gas station food in front of me, I'm taken back to that boat in the bayou. So good. So we're going to go into the next section, which is our, oh, Gloria, yes, barbecue from Texas. There's nothing like it. We're going to do our rosebud thorn. This is one of our favorite activities at Silk and Saunders. The rose is a highlight, something awesome from the week. A bud is an emerging opportunity and a thorn is a challenge. So a highlight from my week is that I was able to teach up to 8 hours of Pilates or other fitness classes a day. That's the most I've ever taught. I've always cut myself off at 7, but I did it, which means I'm getting more confident and it's less exhausting. So that's my rose. My bud is I have a new Pilates client that I'm hoping I'll be able to stick with a little bit longer to get her ready for classes. And she's amazing. I love working with her. And then a thorn is, for whatever reason, I'm dealing with some sort of stomach bug in the last 48 hours, which is not my favorite. Oh, Amber, you're talking my language with Buc-ee's. I love Buc-ee's. Actually, the very first Buc-ee's was right by my house when I was growing up. So I'm going to go off camera. Now, remember, if you are in that May journal, you are filling out your rosebud thorn on page 50. Now, if you are in your June journal, you can do this at any blank section that feels good to you. So I'll go off camera and let you guys share your rose, bud, and thorn. Thank you. Okay, welcome back. Hopefully you don't hear my chihuahua barking in the background. This video usually takes it out. My husband tried to take him on a walk, but since I wasn't going, he had no interest. So I love hearing about what everyone is doing. Life has a lot of ups and downs. Sometimes our thorns are really big. Sometimes they're small. So, you know, I know he didn't even want to go down the stairs without me going. He's such a baby, especially when I'm sick. He's like my little nursemaid. We got definitely a lot of dog people in the house today. So I went to one too many. I like this one to kind of ground us before we jump in to our setup. It is often the small steps, not the giant leaps, that bring about the most lasting change. So what you're reading, what you're eating, what are you filling your bookshelf with? What are you watching on TV? Those little things add up and make us our future self. Our weekly planner is going well. I mean, I know some of you are in May, some of you are in June. Either way, it is fine. But remember, if you had a rough month last month, or you had a rough week, strive for progress, not perfection. You do not have to be perfect at everything. I hate to even show you this, but I'll do it. I'll do it. I'll show you mine. I'll let you see that even though things start out really strong sometimes, you can see there's a lot of empty spaces. So everybody has months like that. So it's okay. I want you to just start over a new month, a new day, a new week, whatever perspective it is that works for you. This is your fresh start. Oh, Rev, I do love Piglet too. I love seeing those videos. Now, if you were brand new, this can be kind of overwhelming. A lot of people don't like to use their journal just as it is. They like to do some repurposing. If you are thinking you want to repurpose some of the areas, you may want to use your phone or your computer to take a screenshot of this page. You can always use your meal planner or food tracker or leftover tracker. Affirmations or scriptures. A work project or study tracker, an exercise tracker. Cleaning plan has been pretty popular lately with that Mama Clean ones, or some of the fly ladies that are among us that may be of the older generation, like myself. Mindfulness activity planner, end of day reflections, writing out your weekly appointments, your garden tracker, a symptom tracker, a dream tracker, listing three or four positives of the day, an outfit tracker, a national day of list. Like today was National Hamburger Day. So Maya went and got a hamburger for lunch, which I thought was so fun. A TV, movie, or maybe a podcast watching plan, a gratitude log, building mini routines, bingo boards, very popular, a hooray list, celebrating good things, even if it's small, or maybe even a 5 cents reflection, going over something that you smell and noticed for your taste and everything, just making you savor all of those moments. And then somebody wanted this quote, so it is up there. Take a quick screenshot of this beautiful quote. Sorry, it is a little bit grainy. I worked on it for a while, but I couldn't get it as clear as I wanted it to. So I'm going to show you some examples of the way other Saunders folks have been using theirs, and then I'm going to break it down in smaller pieces and allow you to have a chance to work. Good, Dawn. Perfect. I'm glad everybody got the quote. It's a good one. So over here on the left-hand side, I really like how their to-dos became a rest, restore, and recuperate, and that their goals were body, mind, and spirit. And I really liked that they wanted to feel it wasn't just a word, but it is sentences. Definitely a way to be able to go out there. And also notice that she has her Silk and Saunders listed in her habit section. There's nothing wrong with that. I do that a lot of the time too, especially after a month that I may not have been as good as other months. Over here on the right, you can see that she kept it very basic. She wants to feel energized. She's listed out her to-dos, and she wants to practice her calligraphy, her TikTok content, and glassing. You're also going to notice that she has some things that are a little bit fun, like practice calligraphy, and that I love that she's trying to get all of her vegetables in as well as those flossing. Over here on the left-hand side is a beautiful bingo board on the to-do list. A lot of people love those bingo boards. And then also I want to point out at the bottom, she wrote Disneyland. So she's not holding herself accountable for that day. She's just going to enjoy the day as it is. Over here on the right, I've had this example for a while, but I cannot get rid of it because there's so many things I absolutely love about it. So she wrote out a lot of words, how she wanted to feel. I also love how she coded her calendar on the top left-hand side of when bills were due, when there was a social or errands that needed to be run. She's also using the Eisenhower matrix of the do, decide, delegate, and delete. We'll look a little deeper into that in a few minutes. And then Jen O has come up with the frog, fun, and fruitful. And so she is utilizing that. That frog is the thing you don't want to do that you should do first thing in the morning. The fun is something fun, and fruitful is, you know, something that you're hoping that is going to end up being fruitful. Over here on the left-hand side, I like that they have the need to do, an accomplishment, a self to do, and a family to do. I thought that was a very clever way to break it down even further. She's also using out the Eisenhower matrix of urgent, not urgent, important, and not important. And over here on the right, on the bottom, is this was from not May, this is May. So April, it was Vibrance. So she made a playlist of Vibrance song. So maybe you are going to want to create a summer playlist for loyalty this next coming month. And I also want to point out that she, depending on how her week looked, she chose a different word of how she wants to feel depending on what was happening that week. I thought that was very smart. Over here on the left-hand side, someone has the important call and other, but look how gorgeous this is. It's like the pretty scrapbooking kind. And she's reading, journaling, meditating, creative, and learning, and listing out beside them what it is that she's utilizing. On the right, this one is actually from our social that Maya did this morning. I love choose what you need to be. So do you need music? Do you need to do some deep breathing? Do you need a walk? I thought that was very clever. And then I know we utilize in our monthly planner on the intentions a lot, the more and less, but she did that in her goals, which I thought it was super smart. And also notice at the bottom, she did not fill up her habit activities. She left some blank. That is also perfectly okay. Crystal, I miss the cooking socials too. I recently posted, I'm like, we should have a poll and then like quarterly do one based on the recipe everybody wants to cook together. So fingers crossed we can get that going again. This week, I want to feel, this is over here on the left-hand side. If you're needing a little inspiration for the word of the day, you might find the word that you need in there, or you might enjoy that feelings wheel. I'm not going to give you a lot of time on this one. I'm just going to flip back and forth between these two as you share in the chat how it is that you want to feel this week. So how is it that you want to feel? Maybe it is excited, or maybe you're revisiting your word of the year, like my word was effervescent. Maybe you're leaning into the theme of the five senses and you're wanting to feel delightful. How do you want to feel? Accomplished, inspired, imaginative, energetic, calm, celebratory, happy 40th, Leanna. Beautiful, excited, committed, focused, crafty, relieved, like Ariel out of the sea. Oh, I hope you're going on vacation, Casey. Centered, celebrated, calm and centered. Awesome. I love that. This week, for me, I am definitely wanting to feel relaxed and calm. Calm is a word that I use. I definitely worked way more than usual. I worked 9 days in a row and I taught 7 extra classes and I had a bunch of extra privates, which is all great, but I was exhausted. So definitely want to feel a little more relaxed and calm this week. We're moving on to our goals. We are still on page 46 if you are in that May journal. If you are in that June, it's page 22. Am I right? Am I right? Did I remember? Nope, not 22. I thought I had it in my head, but I did not. It's 26. Thank you, Amber. Okay, so 3 major goals. Now, I wanted to also give you a little grounding here. You were born to be real, not to be perfect. I want you to keep that in mind. If you are someone like me who has chronic pain, suffering, and you never know when you may be bedridden for a day or so, I want you to not think of setting up your goals and habits as your very best superwoman day. I want you to consider the fact that you need to set yourself up for success. And if you are prone, if it's you get migraines around your period, and this is that time period, give yourself grace. If you're a teacher and you're finishing up the school year, you know you're going to be tired putting all those lit library books back, et cetera. Plan it out. Set the goals that make it work. If you're going on vacation, this may not be time to start a bedtime routine. Keep those things in mind as you move forward with your goal and habit setting. So ways to kind of think about this, you can use your May intentions on page 9. And I do really recommend you going back and looking at your intentions at the beginning of the month, just in case some of them have gone by the wayside. Or some things on your monthly habit tracker. Maybe your habit tracker looks a bit like mine does. You can set goals through the lens of delight. You can create no goals, like no alcohol or no scrolling or no TV during weeknights, however it is that you want to set up. And then look at the previous week's goal journals to see what you have maybe not accomplished that you still find that are important. And I want to say, if you tried a goal and it didn't work for you, it's okay to let it go and just say, yep, I tried it. It didn't work for me. Let's move on and find something that does work for me. Gretchen Rubin from the Happier Podcast and author, you know, her thing is be true to Gretchen. She doesn't like meditation. And so meditating is something she tried, but it's not something that she's going to do. That's okay. You can also frame your goals around a single personal challenge, such as a fitness challenge or cleaning or self-talk, or maybe a soup or salad type of thing there. And those of you who are talking about things that you are wanting to see with those socials, please at the end, fill out that survey so that they can get your feedback so we can make this the best program that fits your needs. So I'm going to leave this up here. I'm going to let you set up your goals. Remember, it can be one goal. It can be three goals. If you got a lot of mini goals, maybe it's five goals. It doesn't have to be three just because it says it was three. All right, I'll give you time to think about it. Okay, so let's dig into the next section. It's getting hot. The sun's starting to come in a little bit, so I shed it in my vest. One too many. Weekly to-dos. I love this one. I'm a very anxious person. I'm very high strung, and I love the fact that it says anxious, but doing it anyway. And that's the way I think a lot of weeks my to-dos look. It's like I'm anxious about this, don't really want to get it done, don't know how it's going to get done, but I'm going to do it anyway. Yes, Dawn, I love that. Keep it simple. You know, like if you're brand new to this, you don't have to fill out everything. You can definitely fill out little sections of it that are going to resonate with you and be helpful for you. And it's going to take a while to use this journal and figure out the best way to make it work for you. And that's completely and totally fine. I always say, this is 3 years in, I've never finished an entire journal. I leave things blank, I use what serves me, and I leave what doesn't. If you are thinking about utilizing this section for your spring routine, here are some ideas that you might think about, like getting spring cleaning in, a nature walk, plant something new, filling out your gratitude journal. People are talking about those strawberries, the first strawberries of the season, really delighting in that. A spring reading list. Gretchen Rubin loves to reread old books from specific authors. Maybe there's a certain genre that really appeals to you during the summertime. Go on a D&D, treat yourself, make a new playlist, go on a picnic, try out a new hobby, spend time with loved ones. Here is also some other ways that people like to utilize them, such as the ta-da bingo. The ta-da are the things that you've accomplished, and then you can write them down when you've accomplished them. I honestly don't know what D&D is either. Maybe someone in there can chime in for us because I'm not positive. Do not disturb. Oh, thank you, Amber. Phone setting. Love it. Here's a bingo board for the to-dos. I don't know, gamifying it sometimes just makes things a little more fun. And maybe if you have some cute stickers, give yourself a little gold star on it. You can also do wants and needs. Remember, the results you want rarely come out of the process of gradual steps towards it first. And then here is how you utilize that Eisenhower matrix. And you know, you can always utilize this any way that you want to. I know, Sarah, I thought Dungeons and Dragons as well. And I was like, that can't be right. That can't be right. Okay, going off camera, I cannot wait to know if you are repurposing or what some of the to-dos you're diving into this week are. Okay, just a reminder, make sure that your chat is set to everyone. Sometimes it likes to default, and some of you are talking and no one's responding because they're not seeing it. The next section is our habit and activity section. And I love this quote too. Be a curator of your life. Slowly cut things out until you're left with only what you love and what is necessary and what makes you happy. So think about that a little bit as you start to fill out your pages. What makes you happy? What are the things you fill your cup and you actually do want to do versus things you think you should be doing? Be true to yourself. Now, some people who are new are like, well, there's a monthly habit tracker and now there's a weekly. What's the difference? Well, the monthly are things you want to do every day. These are things that you maybe you want to do 2 times a week or a little bit like that. If you are looking for some fun things on this one, you can utilize maybe creating a self-care checklist, or maybe you're choosing some self-love habits here that you might want to think about including in your habit tracker. I will go off camera. I'll scroll through those 2 slides if y'all are wanting to grab that quote, and we'll be back in a couple. Okay, so we're heading over to the next section. So you are, if you're in May, you're on page 47. If you are in your June journal, you're looking at page 27. I'm going to go through some examples with you and then give you a big chunk of time to be able to work on it. So, one too many. Over here on the left-hand side, if it doesn't work for you, it's totally fine to change the category. So they changed theirs to quote self-care and then social marketing posts. Over here on the right-hand side, someone is working in pencil, and guess what? It still works. It can be as simple as that. So you can see their to-dos are listing out things they need to do each day of the week, and that they are wanting to feel healthy, and they are going to be eating their thistle meals. And I can totally support that because I eat my thistle meals too. Over here on the left-hand side, they're using this kind of as a way to lean into self-care. And some of these areas didn't work for them, so they are just putting some stickers over it. And if that makes you happy and it makes you, you know, smile when you open the journal in the morning or when you're doing it at night, that's totally fine. It's totally okay. Over here on the right-hand side, they're using it. Their meal planner is a week at a glance of the things they need to do, such as budgets and church and vacuuming. And then their mind body health plan is Ambry, thank you for sharing your picture. They're using their planning out their workouts for it. And then over here on the right hand side, you can see that they are using more than one thing that they are enjoying, and it looks like that shopping list has become a to-do list. Over here on the left-hand side, also love this one. They've created morning and night routines. They use a little code over on the right of how did they respect their mind, body, health that day instead of planning out what's going to happen each day. Also over on the left-hand side, they are tracking their fruits and veggies and the rainbow, because eating the rainbow is so healthy, and always stick with the purple. We don't have enough purple in our diet. That's what I'm learning in health coaching school. Over here on the right-hand side, she's using her shopping list as a packing, and then she just kind of created beautiful art. So that's super fun. Over here on the left-hand side is a bingo list, and they're using their mind body health plan to actually use as journal prompts. And then over here on the right-hand side, we have some affirmations, the types of rest, which is very popular, and then ways that they wanted to make connections with other people. Marking, is it text, is it face-to-face, or is it a call? Now for me, this week is a little bit different. I am utilizing, and I gave y'all the wrong page number, but Maya gave you the right one. I was flipping back to that rosebud thorn. For me, my shopping list is actually becoming a summer bucket list. So that's something to consider. And my meal plan is my study plan, because I need to get some things done for school. So just some of those thoughts that you can definitely dig into. I am going to scroll through these really quickly, and I'll go through them again as you guys are working. If you're not on that Instagram, here are some journal prompts that you might like to use in the meal plan section. Meal plan is definitely the one that gets repurposed the most. And here are some examples of someone using it for their rest or their affirmations or things that they are happening with, also some other ideas. Mind body health plan. If you're not sure of what you want to do for your types of rest, here are some examples. And maybe you categorize your self-care into mental self-care, physical self-care, emotional self-care, and spiritual self-care. Over here, here are some people looking at it in different ways, using it as a meal planner, journaling, a chore bingo. Once again, seven types of rest, some alliteration like meatless Monday, TV free Tuesday, or choosing one of the things that might light them up on side. And as far as shopping goes, this one gets repurposed a lot. I add to mine all week long, but I love this energy giver on the left. So when they are feeling low, they can pick something from their bingo board. Once again, a packing list, shopping list of things that they want, but maybe not gonna buy right away. And then also know that you can throw a quote or errands in there as well. And the very last section that you're going to fill out is things that you are delighting in or loving. So I'm going to go off camera. I'm going to play quite a few songs to allow you to work. Maya and I are in the chat to support you with any questions. We'd love to know how you are repurposing things that you are up to. And don't worry, I will be going through those slides as you work. Thank you. All right, friends, we are coming towards to the end of our time together. Sadly, it went really fast. I just want to show you. Did y'all know at Trader Joe's it's peony season? I had no idea these guys opened and closed every day. They look fake. They're so beautiful. So if you're looking for a way that is calorie-free to treat yourself and you live near a Trader Joe's, run. They're gorgeous. And this one's been here since Wednesday without any issue. All right. Weekly planner, please do share that what you have. Let me start again. Apparently words are hard at this point. Please share in Sonder Club. That's where those examples came from. And so I only had 4 new examples today from this morning, and yesterday no one posted. So that's where we get them. So please do post if you're comfortable doing so. And then let the refer friends still going on. They get 10 bucks, you get 10 bucks. And make sure to share your feedback. Like if you are wanting other types of socials, or you want to be able to see the cooking social comeback quarterly, those types of things. If you're wanting, whatever it is that you're wanting to see, you want to see me do an online easy Pilates class paired with creating meal jars, salad, you know, like whatever. That's where you get to be creative and let us know, because we do read them. And that's where all our wonderful ideas come from. Now, the very last thing is, do know that you need to save that YouTube link if you are new. The chat's not going to be there. Sometimes music isn't, and it takes a few days for it to be listed. But there are tons of other monthly socials that you can watch as well. So I will see some of you again tomorrow. Maya and I will be presenting again. Maya will be there in the morning. And I am just so excited that you are ready and set for this holiday week. I'm going to take us out with a little bit of the Go-Go's. All right, I will see you guys next time.